The highlights for me in the governor's State of the State message was the fact that he placed a lot of emphasis on upstate New York and upstate needs. For example, the 0% tax rate for upstate manufacturers, that's going to help us with our local economic development efforts. The scheduling of an agriculture summit, which will help us with our agricultural endeavors as well, which are important to our local economy, and the emphasis on further promoting upstate tourism. All that's very, very positive in terms of upstate, and I like that emphasis there. Also, the fact that we are dealing now with a budget surplus rather than a deficit, that's a big positive for us as well. And the fact that the governor wants to, and this is something I fully support, return that surplus back to the taxpayers in the form of property tax cuts and relief and further business tax cuts that will help us spur our local economies. And so the fact that there was an emphasis on upstate New York, a surplus rather than a deficit, and an emphasis on broad-based tax cuts, I think are all very, very positive. I was disappointed that the governor did not talk about mandate relief for local governments when he was talking about property tax relief and the need for greater efficiency on the part of local governments. One of the things that drives up the cost of local governments are state mandates. And I'm hoping as we talk about the property tax relief in the future in this session, that I can get a true discussion and some action on state mandate relief so that we can help local governments. Also, when he's talking about sharing of services and consolidation on the part of local governments, we need to come in with some real incentives to help them see that that is financially feasible for them to go that route. I was pleased with the governor's discussion of education and some new investments in our classrooms and in education in our state, the universal pre-K, after-school programs. All that's very, very positive. When we get into the details of education funding this year, I'm also going to be pushing for an equitable distribution of the state aid to our school districts. Our local school districts have been hit hard with this gap elimination adjustment, which actually cuts their local state aid and has the last few years. We need to eliminate the gap elimination adjustment. That will help us with our funding of our local schools and also help our local school property taxpayers. Overall, the governor's the tone in his speech was one of working together, getting a positive results for the people of the state of New York. And I look forward to working with the governor, my colleagues in the Senate and the Assembly to make some good things happen this year for our upstate region and our hard-pressed taxpayers.